We're so close. The signal's coming from just beyond this ridge.
Stay on the lookout. You see any movement, run.
Sit tight, people. I'm gonna clear the way. It's time for some answers. What do we have here? Zahidi, I found some more writing from Monroy's people. I think we must be approaching their colony. It seems Monroy didn't believe the Pax were so peaceful. When their tech started getting fried, he suspected the Pax were trying to sabotage him. Then, just as a storm was brewing up, they caught the Pax doing one of their obelisk rituals.
Did Monroy think the Pax were causing the storms?
I thought the same thing when I first saw August in those ruins in the forest.
Monroy ordered his soldiers to stop them. It was on that day that Dr. Adira recorded the first Pax deaths.
Please, collect all the writing you can find for me. Perhaps we can learn their story.
Thank you. After the first big storms burned out most of their tech, sounds like Monroy got furious. He demanded explanations from the Pax and access to their powers, but they didn't understand. They offered everything they could. They led Monroy through the jungle to their sacred city.
Probably this city. The place we've discovered.
Thank you.
Zach's took him to the Grand Temple, tried to show him how they communed with the anomaly. But Monroy thought it was a ploy to assassinate him. He ordered the executions of the Pact's leaders and locked down the temple until he could learn how to control it himself.
My God. Monroy, he misunderstood everything the Pact did.
They're countless cages here. If they're filled with skeletons, they look like pack skeletons. After they'd executed the Pact's leaders, Monroy's people started moving into the city. This was their colony. They took over the homes of the Pacts, forcing them to work for them, to serve them.
In other words, they made them slaves. They believed the loss of their machinery was the Pacts' fault.
Doesn't matter what they believe. There's no excuse for enslaving another race.
Thank you.
reminds me of home. Better in Beauvoir's museum than here. There's gotta be hundreds of dead packs here, executed, piled up. This whole city is a mass grave.
Monroy's people, they did this.
I think it's getting real clear who the packs were scared of, who they changed themselves into ferals to protect themselves from.
This place, it was a slave market. Seems like they got hit by the worst storm yet. Hundreds died, humans and packs. Some of the obelisks were damaged too, so whatever the packs once were doing to control the storms, they couldn't do it anymore. He feared an uprising, losing control as packs started to abandon the city. Nikolai Galyatkin, Monroy made him general and put him in charge of weapons production.
No doubt the same weapons the Ferals used against them later.
Monroy. This palace is covered with flags, all with... It's gotta be his face. He made himself king of the Pax.
A king?
A tyrant.
Thank you.
Monroy was sending out raids to hunt down the fleeing packs. And that's when the uprising he'd predicted finally found them. But it wasn't the packs. At least, not as he expected.
The Ferals. He never saw them coming.
But Monroy didn't retreat. That asshole dug in out there, in the desert, and tried to track them down where they were coming from. That's when he found the canyon and the Great Obelisk. He finally understood there who the Ferals were. But that's when he got word that the city was under attack.
And so it was. The beginning of the end.
Found Dr. Indira's last journal.
How do you know?
Because she wrote it just before getting executed. By Monroy. She tried to broker a truce with the Pax, thinking she could stop the Ferals if she surrendered Monroy to them. Made it to the top. Palace is clear.
What do you see?
You better come up here and see for yourself.
Monroy was a madman.
Hey, there's a ship!
Is that the Caravel?
That's not possible. The Caravel never left Earth. Its engines exploded. Tens of thousands died.
Then what the hell are we looking at?
The source of the fucking signal. Monroy's signal. There's no place beyond the storm. It's coming from in there, protected from the anomaly, just like the uplink in your goddamn briefcase.
I don't fucking understand.
Neither do I. It doesn't make any sense. Everyone saw the Caravel explode during its construction. Even if the people left on Earth were able to rebuild the ship, they left after us. We were the first. Nevertheless, what's certain is that Monroy enslaved August's people. He butchered them, and they turned. They mutated into savages willingly, so they could fight back.
I'm done. With all this, whatever's waiting for you on that ship, I want no part of it.
Tiago, you can't leave us now.
I thought you weren't a deserter.
What they did to August's people. What our people did to August, don't you see? Thank you for letting me walk a ways with you.
We're going to finish this. We're finding a way into the caravel.
This is it now. That ship, the signal, the garden. I'm ready to make some sense of all this. We'll leave on your word, Outrider.
There has to be a way inside the ship. I'll radio when I've secured a path.
There's no place beyond the anomaly. Why are we still heading to this stupid ship?
If the signal is shielded from the anomaly inside, it means we can use the uplink in there to contact the Flores. All the supplies, the resources, the tech. We're gonna bring them down today.
Not done going through hell yet. When the pack started to flee the city, Monroy rounded up every last one of them that stayed behind, that were loyal and trusting, and threw them into these labor camps.
But I know of the packs, they could not have survived long in there.
It was all Monroy. When he understood the packs were turning into ferals, he sent out an order to murder them all before they could transform.
All of them.
All but enough to run his camp. It's a diary from Nikolai Galiakian, Monroy's general. Seems he was overcome with remorse at the end for what he had been a part of. He didn't retreat to the caravel. He decided to walk away from it all. Right into an anomaly storm.
Good.
Madame Beauvoir would make of this. Monroy returned to the city to find it under siege. They battled for days, a complete bloodbath. And then, another storm hit. Monroy's people were decimated. That's when they spotted the Floris in orbit and called for help.
They started broadcasting the signal.
But it couldn't get through. Help never came. And Monroy ordered a retreat to their ship and locked it down.
Thank you. all this time, all we've been through, the battlefields, the jungles, the alien ruins, the desert, all we've lost. I can't believe we're finally here. The goddamn signal I heard the day we landed, and still, none of it makes any sense.
Oh, I think I'm starting to put it all together. The way the Pax controlled the anomaly with their obelisks, they are what kept the planet's energy in check. They were the balance. But when Monroy stopped the Pax from using the obelisks out of pure fear of what he couldn't understand, the anomaly spread like wildfire across the planet, the storm surging out of control, mutating everything.
All this time, thinking we were going to reach a place beyond the anomaly, only to find the place it all started, where Monroy started it.
They're the ones who got left behind. And half of them probably slaughtered the rest for a last seat on the caravel. Tanner and Yakum, we all should have been down there with the rest. Hopeless. Drowning us. Nothing but dictators and madmen set loose.
If the caravel's engine hadn't exploded and killed most of the Outriders,
we would have been the ones left on Earth. Two more soldiers in Monroy's damn army, fighting for off the Earth. Coming here to slaughter the Pax. It's screwing up the whole damn planet before you all ever set foot on it.
I'm inside the ship. It's still operational.
Whatever's playing the signal, it's in here. Let's finish this together.
Let's finish this. The end of the road, one way or another.
Despite everything, we've brought the uplink all this way. I wish Jane could see us.